青蛙搬家。青蛙和大雁一家是邻居，他们常常在一起玩耍，感情非常好。
A frog was the neighbor of the wild goose. They often played together, and they got along well with each other.
可是过了不久，他们住的地方开始干旱了。大雁渐渐不习惯这样的生活，他决定搬家。
But before long,The place they lived in became dry. The wild goose gradually couldn't adapt to such life, so they decided to move out.
这天，他们向青蛙告别。青蛙不想和他们分开，但它又不会飞，这可怎么办呢？
One day, they said goodbye to the frog. The frog didn't want to separate with them, but he couldn't fly. How should they do?
青蛙有办法。他说，找一根小棍儿，你们摇两边，我摇中间，你们不就可以把我带走了吗？
The frog got an idea. He said,Take a small stick. You bat the both sides, and I bat the middle. Can't you take me along?
于是，青蛙找来一根小棍子，大雁咬住两头，青蛙咬住中间，它们就飞上了天。
Hence, the frog sought a small stick. The wild goose.Beat the both sides of the stick, and the frog beat the middle. Finally, they flew up together.
他们飞过一个村子，人们看见了，都说：“大雁真聪明。”青蛙心想：“这办法是我想出来的。”
When they flew over a village, people saw them and said,The wild goose are so clever. The frog thought that it was me to figure out its way.
他们飞呀飞呀，又过了第二个村子，人们也是这样喊着。青蛙听后非常生气。
They flew and flew, then they flew over the second village.He was sad the same words. When the frog heard the words, he was very angry.
他们飞过第三个村子，很多人又喊了起来。快来看呀，大雁带着青蛙飞，大雁真聪明。
When they flew over the third village, the people thought it again. Look at the wild goose.They are flying with the frog. The wild goose are so clever.
青蛙生气极了，就大声嚷起来：这办法是我想出来的。可他刚张开嘴，就从天上掉下来了。
The frog was so angry that he thought it lovely. It is the way I figured out.Dropped down just when he opened his mouth.